I greet you all, lovers of freedom. For those of you who come across this particular program, I don't ignore it because it is something very, very educative. You will really need it. Don't jump this particular clip. Don't jump it. Make sure you make many other Biafrans to see this. And also, if you have your friends who always argue with you, those of the Yorubas and the Fulani and other tribes who don't believe in our Biafran cause and or who hates on us and have said, because I have seen severally on the social media space, Facebook to be specific, you know, this particular clip, this particular video, it trended some 1 week ago plus and or thereabout, and many people will see it and jump it because it's not anything related to our struggle, but it's good you just watch it and make sure you share it to all Biafrans and in all our platforms. Share this, and in all any social media space you find yourself, share this and make sure you are relating it to our struggle. Okay, this is it here. I will play. Maybe as I play, I explain, or I will allow it to play, then let me bolden it. Yeah. Now, you can see these two women. One of them is very fast and looks very much more flexible and fit. That she is demonstrating very well. From this activity, you see the two of them venturing to. You can see that I have to pause to draw this home very well. Here, this other lady that is in competition with this one that is on green, is it a jab? That other one, when she went the middle halfway, she made a very significant mistake. But she did not insist, maybe, or complain. She just wildly and jaggedly returned back to start afresh. While she went back, the other of her contemporary, the one in the contest with her on the green hijab, proceeded, because she's faster. And physically looking at her, outwardly looking at her, she's faster. And you see her, let us continue playing it. And you see her, she is doing it very fast. She is fixing it. Don't cut short. Make sure you watch to the end so that you get it very clear. This is all about life. And this is what has happened in our struggle. Now you see her doing it. She is the one that is winning. Now you take a peripheral look at this. Now she is the winner. One would already conclude the other one is not serious. Yes. These are the things that have been said about us. Oh, this struggle you are doing. Ojuku did it, and what happened? He did it and he died. Oh, this struggle. Oh, Wazirike did it. Where is he today? Oh, if this struggle, Nnamdi Kanu, you can see where he is. Why do you think Simon Ekpa can succeed? Why did he? Just look at it. Never giving up. Now, see that woman is still back there. She is not distracted by the fact that this one that is in competition with her is already fast, even finishing the third phase of the contest. Why she is still struggling with that particular earlier stage of the context, which is the beginning, the first step. Why the second woman have passed the first, passed the second step, and is in the very last stage. The other lady, now she is just coming. She's not losing focus. All the blackmail, all the information, disinformation, all the rumors, everything done to discourage our struggle, we have remained very focused. When they tell you, you don't have money, who are you to fight with the federal government? Who are you? You cannot contest with government. You cannot fight government. And we have always referred to them. We say, go and check the Talibans. The Talibans in, this is Iran neighbor. The Al-Qaeda's. The Talibans in, where America was stayed for 21 years. And they were patiently pushing, waiting for America to go. They waited for America to go. They waited patiently. They weren't even striking, especially when Donald Trump took over. When it was the right time for them to show, when it was the ripe of the time, when it is in the good favorable hand of clock, the time, the destiny time, the destined time, America had to go. They had to strike, and they took over. You see this lady? You see the consistency, never quitting. Unlike those who would want to be saying they are doing freedom, tomorrow they say this political solution, and their political solution, the people they are doing the solution with told them there is no room. Nobody is negotiating now. Can you see this woman has emerged victorious? This is exactly what happens in the journey of life. Nobody who first start the run, nobody who first be like say Naim they win, nobody who first do like say Naim be James Bond. Now you can see that the other woman is not happy. The way she brushed the shoulder of the winner, you see her facial expression. Yes, don't ever expect the person you are in context with to be happy. If you are in context with a party and the party is comfortable, happy with you, it's not disturbed by your activities, you are not in any context. You are deceiving yourself, or you are a very highly shameless, compromised person like the DOS people who are telling the world that they are doing freedom with Nnamdi Kanu and Simon Ekpa. The woman, you saw how she expressed unhappiness with the person that eventually won. But when she was winning, she didn't bother how the other woman felt. And the other woman was not disturbed. She took it. It is a journey of life. One person will always emerge victorious. But most often, not the person that you see with the early signs of being the victor. That early signs, that person you see, you know, showing swag, most times don't be the one that wins on the long run. Look at this, our struggle. They have thrown different stud. We jump, we pass. They kept throwing stud. They will infiltrate the fold with the distractors and detractors. In all, we keep escaping, we keep skipping, jumping and passing, and we are here where we are today, where they are crying, oh, I will go and kidnap, I must go and arrest, he must be deported, he must be repatriated, So you always want the person you are in contest with to be crying. You are the one good to be winner. Others are not good to win. You can see that. All along in the struggle, they have always told you, oh, leave this your struggle. Suppose that one will come and say, the Supreme Court governor, this one will come and tell you, oh, Dojuku started it. This one started it. This one, what are you doing? This one, what do you have? How can you stand the government? You cannot stand the government. Have you ever seen anybody's government? go to Afghanistan, go to Afghanistan and ask the Talibans, were you able to stand the government? Were you able to overpower the government? Were you able to sack the government? Are they spirits and you are animals? The Talibans are human beings. They ousted the government constituted by human beings. So why are you always quick to give discouraging things, words coming from politicians, and you help them to sell it? Oh, how can you fight the government? How can you win? You expect to win. And they will tell you, okay, this is Taliban, this is Afghanistan, not that. And you wonder, an Islamic state, a strong Islamic state that understands the weaponry more than you, was ousted. The government was ousted. And Afghanistan Talibans took over. And they are human beings. They did it. It worked. Why do you listen to neophytes who don't even have the strength to even read or get updated with developments of things around them, around the world? All this, you want to listen to your big bellies, your biggie belly people, where we say they don't even have the time to even read. They don't finish with all their shower when they around campuses. What do they even know their left or their right? Is it not the people who occupy office and have 52 heads on how to, this one is responsible on how to even make a sentence, the other one is on guide on how to even step outside, how to control your public carriage? No, they don't even know anything on their own. Why do you want to get to make, why are you determined to get the Biafran people discouraged in this pursuit? Why? You think they will make you promise and keep to it? They will not keep to any promise if they make. What they tell you, like I said earlier, if you go to social media, whenever there is any sensitive discourse that has to do with Biafran agitation and the freedom fight, you will see a lot of Yoruba names these days, including some Igbo people. They want to sabotage what we are doing. They want to sabotage the effort. But we are aware of all their measures to sabotage us. We are unwavered. Yes. We are not disturbed. We are focused. You see that lady, very focused. The lady in competition with her, where while she was still in number one, that one already finished with number one stage, enter number two stage, finished, enter number three stage. But when it was the ripe of time, when she was ready to take the next level step, that other lady in competition with her was still, for so long time, still at that finishing touch, and she came to meet her and still won and left her behind. And she went home with the big package. That is what happened in that video. Sefeni, Chikina Kawai. Sefeni. Ogusiwo. So I don't want to bore you with a lengthy time and discourse. This is just what I have come to give. I greet you. Akpanakpana Soko from Biafra Radical Freedom TV. Please do good to subscribe to this channel if you are not subscribed to it. And like or click on the notification key so that you'll be getting our updates. Like and also drop comments. share this whenever it comes to you. Please share it. God bless you.